Hello everyone, myself Architect Kanika Verma, an assistant professor at APJ School of Architecture Planning, Greater Noida. I welcome you all in this ongoing online lecture series for subject research with subject code RAR408 under AKTU syllabus. In continuation with my previous lecture, in today's lecture I would be focusing on referencing style and various other important components of referencing and referencing style. Before we start, let's have a quick revision what all we have covered in the previous lecture. So we have talked about what is referencing. As already mentioned, in academic writing and scientific research, it seems important and rather crucial to base new findings or investigation on facts or on previous results and show the context of the subject within the discipline. Therefore, we refer others published or unpublished source of information which we need to cite or referenced in the body of research. In second segment, we have talked about why do we need to do referencing. We need to do it to uphold intellectual honesty, to attribute prior work or ideas to the correct sources, to allow reader to determine independently whether the reference material supports the author argument, does it provide necessary validation, to help the reader gauge the strength and validity of the material used, and last, to avoid plagiarism. In third segment, where we need to learn how to do referencing, we have already covered what all should be referenced, what are the elements of referencing in general. And in today's lecture, we would be focusing on a very important component of elements of referencing, that is unique identifiers. In further segment, we'll talk about importance of different referencing styles and we'll cover a style in detail, that is APA style. So what are unique identifiers and how they are different from various elements of referencing? As we know, elements of referencing inform us about the author of the research, where it has been published, in which year it has published, who was the publisher, etc., in order to reach to the source. However, none of these particulars of information is sufficient to take you to the source single-handedly. To make you understand it better, we can compare research with a human being who has associated information like name, birthplace, profession, height, and other physical attributes which can be used to identify that specific human being. But none of these can work in seclusion. What does it mean? It means that even if we are aware of the name of the person or the birthplace, we may not able to trace the same person, because there can be many persons with the same name in the same area. But individual fingerprints can help to identify that person, as they are unique for every single human being on earth. Similarly, unique identifiers work for publications and writing materials. But there's a limitation which we need to understand, that they need to be generated, given, stored at a database, so that we can recollect the source of information. In today's lecture, we would be focusing on four unique identifiers which are practiced globally. However, there are many identifiers practiced for different disciplines. We would be only focusing on four, that is ISBN, ISSN, SISCI and DOI. ISBN is the most known and recognized unique identifier used for book publications. It is a numeric commercial book identifier which is intended to be unique. It is assigned to each separate edition and variation for publication unless it is reprinting. For example, if you have ebook, a paper book, a hardcover edition of the same content, means the same book, you will have different ISBN numbers given for each type of book. ISBN generally issued by the ISBN registration agency that is responsible for that country or territory regardless of the publication language. Publisher generally need to purchase ISBN number from an affiliate of international ISBN agency. However, it is considered identifier, but it does not convey any form of legal or copyright protection. But in some countries, the use of ISBN identifies as a legal deposit or a requirement framed by the government to identify publication. To help you understand this elaborate large digits of ISBN was initially framed within the 10-digit number. Until January 2007, it has been start coming with a prefix of 978 or 979. So there are five components within this ISBN number. First, represent the prefix, as I said. The second is the registration group, which identifies particular country, geographical region, language area, whatever areas they are participating in the ISBN system. The third represent the registrant element, which identifies particular publisher or the imprint. So this largest code given to the publisher represent the number given to various publishers. It can be old publisher, new publisher, all will have a separate number. The fourth component represent the publication element, which identifies the particular edition and format of a specific title. The last single digit represent the check code, which validate rest of the number. So ISBN is calculated using a specific mathematical formula in order to generate a unique formation for all publication use the ISBN number. Another known unique identifier is ISSN, that is International Standard Serial Number, used for periodical publications. It is an 8-digit code used to identify a newspaper, journal, magazine, and periodical of all kinds and all media, be it print or electronic. As it says, it identifies publications of various kinds. However, it does not include any information about the origin or content of the publication. It also don't guarantee the quality or validity of the content. It is generally associated with the title, but the type, if the publication has been modified significantly, a new ISSN must be assigned to it. In many countries, an ISSN is mandatory for all the publications subject to legal deposit. For you to understand the digits given in the ISSN, this 8-digit code is divided by a hyphen into 4-digit numbers. First 7 digits represent as an integer number, and the last single digit represent the check code, which validates the rest of the number. As said, ISSN is a media-oriented number. Different medias like print media and electronic will have different ISSN number given. As mentioned in the example below, ISSN with the print media will be given by pin PISSN and electronic will be EISSN respectively. Now, SICI, that is Serial Item and Contribution Identifier. It has been generally assigned to a specific volume or an article or a particular part of a periodical publication. It does not represent the publication itself, but a segment of it. It may be a table or appendix or something which represented by a unique content, which is given by a SICI number. It corresponds generally to ANSI or NISO, it generally appears printed on an actual journal issue from that publisher. To understand the number given, it has three segments coded within. First represent the item segment, second is the contribution segment, and last, third is the control segment. The first segment talks about and gives you the information about the publication itself. So the first number, which is 0002 and 8231, it gives you the information about the ISSN, which represent the journal magazine it belongs to. Part 2 represent the parentheses and identifies the date and publication. Here it is mentioned as 199412, which means December 1994 was the year of publication. The last part signifies the volume and the number. So volume 45 and number 10 represent the item itself. The second major segment talks about the contribution, which talks about the location code, title code of the contributor. The final segment talks about the controller, which has various identifier and codes like code structure identifier, derivative part identifier, format identifier, to make it a valid unique identifier for that portion of periodical publication. Now, DOI as unique identifiers. Digital object identifiers are managed by International Organization for Standardization, that is ISO. DOI can identify creative works like text, images, audio, video, softwares, journal, individual articles, a single table, in both electronic and physical form. DOI generally do not depend on object's location, that is why it's quite similar to URN. It has document which remain fixed over lifetime of the document, where its location and other related data may change. DOI has two components to understand, a prefix and a suffix separated by a slash, where prefix identifies the registrant of the identifier. Suffix is chosen by registrant and identifies the specific object associated with that DOI. DOI is different from standard identifiers such as ISBN, as the purpose of identifier registry is to manage a given collection of identifier. DOI make a collection of identifier actionable and interchangeable, where the data collected can include identifiers from many other control collections. Now, let's move towards the next segment of our presentation, that is referencing style, and learn what are the importance of referencing style. As it says, legibility of information to identify the source. It means how easily one can read through the arrangement of coded information specified by that style. Second importance is it can be used as the markers of identity. Means it can be used to establish an image and distinct character for one's publication. There are some journals and papers which are known by their house styles. Third importance is the representative of scientific communities and groups. Means use of a particular style can be recognized as association, common beliefs, to orient research in certain manners which are practiced by a set of people, communities and groups. Fourth importance is the pedagogical method of program. It means universities, schools and programs may have a specific style which adhere to the system adopted for learning and various other attributes of knowledge sharing. The last important is literary preferences of different journals or editor. It represents the qualitative measures and ways of writing preferred by journals and editors. As mentioned earlier, a reference style determines how the elements of all citation will look like or arranged, and how the information will be given within the body of the research, like in the footnote or as an entry in the list of reference or bibliography. It informs a lot of details about the way of writing. Broadly, there are three families of referencing style. The first one is the author-date style of referencing, which refers to the work by their author and year of publication in the text and lists the full citation alphabetically in the bibliography or reference list. The most common example is APA and MLA, which are the most known style of referencing. It generally practiced and used in social science and medicine as a discipline. MLA is another iteration of APA only, where it used the author date kind of a citation in the body. The second style is the numeric style of referencing, which refers to work in the text and include a bibliography in which every work is associated with a number at the end. Wherever the citation is repeated within the body of work, the same number will be used in the text and in the citation. AMA is a very known example of this kind of a style of referencing. Discipline like science and engineering practice numeric style of referencing. However, there are many commonalities between various numeric styles, like order of elements, use of italics and abbreviated. But the most visible difference are in in-text citation, which are alternatively numbers in parentheses, square brackets or superscript. In coming presentation, we will be discussing Vancouver, which is an example of a numeric style of referencing, in detail. The third style of referencing is the note style of referencing, which is said to be the first and oldest family of styles known to the human. Chicago Manual style and MHRA are two examples of this note style of referencing. The details of note styles vary significantly. Some styles, particularly in older works and journals, include full bibliographic details in notes and does not include a bibliography. However, some ways the endnotes being replaced by the footnotes. Other variants of this family include short notes, like the name of the author, title of the publication, and author and year in footnote as well as in the bibliography. It is generally practiced in discipline like history and humanities. We will be covering MHRA as note style of referencing in details. Now let's talk APA style in details. APA stands for American Psychological Association. That kind of style evolved in late 1920s with a set of people coming from the fields of psychology, anthropology and business management. Right now, the 7th edition of this kind of a style has been published in October 29th and is in use. APA is said that's the author date reference style, which means that in-text references are given within the parentheses. APA style give instructions for all kind of a writing like books, chapter, journal, web page, newspaper, magazine, reports, study materials and various other types. We'll try to cover some of these in detail. Now, how to apply APA style in in-text citation? As it is shown here, you can propose it two ways. First, when you want to emphasize upon the author name, you tend to write the name first and then give the year of publication and then further on elaborate the statement stated by the author. Example stated in the first highlighted box, which says, example, Stevenson 2003 proposed that so and so. However, if you don't want to emphasize on the author, you need to give the citation after the statement. So, the second box suggests that statement stated in bracket Stevenson in 2003. Similarly, when you know the details of page numbers, you can provide it as example stated below in the highlighted box. Now, how to use the APA style for second-hand use of sources? What do you mean by second-hand sources? When the actual source is not used directly, however, you are referring to the piece of writing which has used someone else's piece of information in their own book of writing. So you generally tends to use quote or cited in your own piece of citation. So the example highlighted states, the statement said is nonlinear systems are ubiquitous as mathematician, which is quoted in Campbell in 1985, page number 374, which was further referenced by Lansing 2003 at page number 183. So this way you're able to quote the original author and the author who have used it at first place. In second example, when the direct quotation has not used but just a matter of citation, therefore the second author has mentioned as cited in Damhoff 1996, which was the year of publication. The author was Lewis, who used it in 2008 at page number 182. Now, how do we use APA style to generate reference list? Every entry in an APA reference list has a hanging indent, which means that every line after the first is moved a few spaces to the right. Entries are always placed in alphabetical order according to the first author listed. Different type of sources have different formats, and everything about each entry from the punctuation to the capitalization of words is strictly prescribed. Punctuation are very important in references, and use of same punctuation like commas, full stops and brackets is highly prescribed. The example mentioned here in the white box illustrate the order used for a publication with two authors and two publishers. It says that the surname must come first, followed by the initial of the author's name. If there are two authors, one must use end in between the two authors' name, and again the author's surname comes first, followed by a comma and the initials of second authors. The year of publication always be placed within a bracket. Title of publication is highlighted by using italics, as you can clearly stated here. Here, where there are two publishers, the semicolon is used to differentiate between the two. Examples: in this example, you can see Thomson and Southwestern are separated by a semicolon. Wherever there is a year of publication is not mentioned with the source, one must write n.d, which says that there is no date available. Months and dates can also be appeared after the year of publication if it is available to write. For referencing a book with one author, APA suggests author's last name first, followed by a comma, then initial of the author, then year of publication within the bracket, then the title of the publication or the book in italics, then place of publication, followed by a colon, and then the publisher. Here, one must consider that only initials are mentioned for the author's first name instead of the full name. Year of publication refers to the edition instead of the year where the book has been written. The title has been highlighted by using italic way of writing. and the first word of the title is capitalized. For place of publication, APA generally prefer the recommend city plus abbreviated name of state for US publication, and for others, city and the country for other than non-US publications. Publishers suggest the name of the publishing company. Another important factor is, generally the titles, specifically the title of books, only have uppercase letters for the first word of the title and the first word of any subtitle with proper nouns. The example stated within is, the Ballard is the author's surname or the second name. K is the first name, the initials of it. 2001 is the year of publication, or probably the year of edition. Title of publication is the frameworks of English, that is introducing language structures, which is highlighted in italic. Then the place of publication, and then the publisher. Now, referencing book with more than two authors. So whenever there are two authors, important point is, there is the use of and between the separation of two names of the authors. So first author's last name followed by a comma, then initials of first author's name, then and, then the second author's last name followed by a comma, again the initials of second author's name, second author's first name, then year of publication, always in bracket, then the title of book, one can choose the italic, then the place of publication, then colon, and then the publisher. But if there are more than two authors, then the end always used before the last author's name, with the same preference given where the author's last name comes first and then the initial follows. Rest of the body remains the same. For referencing journal article, the order suggested by APA is more or less the same with some added details. So the author last name, comma, then the initial of the first name, year of publication within parentheses, within the bracket, the title of article, then the title of journal, volume number, inclusive page numbers, and DOI if it is given, which is a unique identifier. Points to consider here are that other than the proper nouns, only the first word of the article title is capitalized. Italic is used for journal titles and volume numbers. Journal titles are capitalized. Inclusive page number cover the whole article, not only the part of the article to which you refer. If a DOI is provided and available, you must give it with the referencing at the end of it. Now, how to do referencing for a chapter in an edited book? As the order suggested by APA, again the author's last name, comma, initials, then year of publication within parentheses, then the title of chapter, in name of editor, which is given by EDS or EDS if there are more editors, then the title of book, page numbers of chapter within parentheses, then place of publication, colon, and then publisher. Example stated here clearly demonstrate the order. Now, use of APA style for electronic publication. Here the order suggested for web page. Author, or if there are more authors, then name of the authors, followed by a full stop, year of publication in brackets, page title in italics, and the URL, which is very important to provide. Points to consider that we must give the full URL address as it appears in your browser's address bar. And one must not use full stop at the end of the URL as it may affect the functionality of the link. So the example provided here suggests the piece of information has come from Ministry for Primary Industries, written in 2012. The sub page was rural communities and URL suggested and given here. However, APA style gave referencing for all online and electronic media like online book, online journal article, online magazine article, newspaper article. They have various ways to write it, but in this presentation we are not focusing on all online writing material. Another example stated just for the reference is the encyclopedia entry online, where the author suggests the author name first, then the year of publication, again in brackets, entry title, the site name highlighted in italic, date of retrieval and the full URL. Other than referencing, APA style suggests ways of formatting for the writing. Being established and issued by the American Psychological Association, APA guidelines include information regarding scientific objectivity in writing, which emphasize on a gender-neutral language that suggests that one must not use he, she or it in the body of work. They also recommend unbiased language in academic writing. The use of capitalization is highlighted, as in the running test, title of articles and books are capitalized, but in list of references, only journals are highlighted. If a title consists two segments, then they must be separated by a colon. Then the second segment of the first part of the second segment must be highlighted by a capital word. For general information like giving the idea of what is noun, the name of the people, places, institution, capital word used for the first letter. The use of sick, if there is a spelling mistake or any other error happened within the text, that can be quoted and the writer can point out by adding the word sick after the inaccurate word or phrase. The sick also plays after the word to which the writer wishes to draw the reader's attention. That was all for today's lecture. We would continue learning referencing style. For more style of referencing like note style and number style in upcoming videos. These were the references I have used in order to generate an effective presentation and to help you learn referencing. Thank you.